ഒറ്റപ്പാലം 24th November 1923. Notes taken by Swami Amalanandaji. Do his work. Swami Nirmalanandaji said, Sri Ramakrishna is Mother Divine. We are his children. The mother knows the wants of her children. You need not ask for anything. Sri Guru Maharaj cooked rice and very nice things, and we are invited to partake of them. We have simply to fall to. There is no need of tapasya or meditation. Have faith in him. The faith of Nachiketas. The faith that will move mountains from your path. He and his cause are one. Work for his cause with your whole heart and soul. Our energy is to be used for that. He has the key of the chest of realization in his hands. He wanted Swami Vivekananda to do his work. After the work was finished, Swamiji realized the highest and went into Samadhi. The key is handed over to his children for the good of humanity. Obey the commander. Sri Guru Maharaj is the commissioner and Swamiji is his chief assistant. We are his constables. Obey the commander-in-chief. Why should you know his plans? The soldier's interest in his wife and children and others will be taken care of by the commander. Let our body, mind and soul be our commanders. Swami Vivekananda is the commander-in-chief, Lord Subramanya. Obey him and success will be yours. No use of ochre robe or Swami or Ananda without faith. Ramakrishna Mission. Sri Guru Maharaj is no form or person, but a principle, the same principle that manifested as Rama and Krishna. You may question the historicity of Rama and Krishna, but not of Ramakrishna. The form of Rama or Krishna is not suited to this time to effect the spiritual conquest of the world. Hence, the principle manifested itself in the form of Ramakrishna. Ramakrishna came to vitalize all forms, the old as well as the new. He came to prove that the essence of all the Vedas, Puranas and Upanishads is true, that all religions are true. These are his words. Sri Ramakrishna is Sri Ramakrishna. A flash will come and then you will understand. Now have faith in what I say and everything will come. You have renounced everything and surrendered at his feet. You have insured your life. It is safe in his hands. He is the Angul Moon of all, from the Brahmin to the Chandala. Sincerity, purity of character, these are the foundation on which you have to build. Untiring work is the brick. Patience is the cement. The Gita for all humanity. Look at Sri Krishna. What an autocrat. Everyone should worship him. Otherwise there is no salvation. What an autocrat. There is no committee, government. But note this. The Gita, the essence of all Upanishads, is meant not for the Brahmins alone, but for all men, down to the lowest Chandalas. He was the perfect autocrat to establish the widest spiritual democracy. The words addressed by him are meant for all humanity, for the salvation of all. Through them, Vedanta was broadcast to the whole world. the Gita message again. Once again, it was broadcast to the four corners of the earth from the platform of the Parliament of Religions at Chicago. The modern world was told in modern words that all religions are true, that truth will be accepted, and that truth will triumph in the end. The source from which it emerged may be denied by many, but impartial historians will trace it to the fire of spirituality that blazed under the banyan tree at Dakshineshwar. Sri Krishna and Ramakrishna are the same. It is not that everyone will worship the photo of Sri Guru Maharaj, but everyone will ultimately accept the truths that he taught and Swamiji proclaimed. Spiritual treasure house. What a marvel was Ramakrishna. What a reservoir of concentrated spirituality. More than enough to deluge the whole world. Bhagavan acquired all that not for himself, but for all the world. What a life work it was to gather and store so much. Who has done so much before? Bhagavan gave that treasure to Swamiji, who in turn gave it to so many. Through them, the spiritual current will flow to many a parched field, and it will go on until the whole store is distributed among all. In the initial stages of our spiritual life, there is need for a guru. Later on, you will find that the external guru is dispensed with and your consciousness becomes the guru. In the beginning also, it was really your own consciousness that inspired you to approach the external guru. In prayer, there is an outpouring of the heart's desire to your ishtam, and hence it presupposes words. Meditation is of two kinds. In one, you meditate upon your ishtam. In the other, you merge yourself in your ishtam. These are the words of Swami Nirmalanandaji Maharaj, monastic disciple of Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna. Jai Sri Ramakrishna.